Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this linear algebra problem. It says let v1, v2, v3, and v4 be these four vectors and h be the span of the four vectors. Find a basis for h, and it also asks to find the dimension of h. So this is a basis and a dimension problem. So first thing, let's go over the definition of a basis. So getting the definition from my textbook, a subset B of a vector space V is a basis for V if B spans V and B is linearly independent. So for this problem, we're given that vectors 1, 2, 3, and 4 span H, which is what we're looking to find a basis for. So we already have the first part completed, and we don't have to worry about any of these vectors spanning H because we know that they do. So now we just have to find which vectors in the span are linearly independent. And once we find the second part, then we can say those set of vectors, or that vector or those set of vectors span and are linearly independent, and so they form a basis for V. So let's go ahead and do that. To prove that a set of vectors are linearly independent, we're going to take v1, v2, v3, and v4 and rewrite it as a matrix. And then we're going to do row reduced echelon form. And any non-zero vectors that are left over in the matrix will be linearly independent. Okay, so I'm going to combine v1 through 4. So negative 2, negative 3, 1, 4, 6, negative 2, 7, 10, negative 3, 3, 7, negative 4. And I think I've already made a video on how to do row reduced echelon form. It's basically row echelon form, and then the leading coefficients have to be 1. So I'm going to do R2 plus 2R1, R4 plus R1 to get that matrix. And then I'm going to do R1 plus 2R4. And R3 minus 7R4. And then I'm going to switch row 2 and row 4. And I'm going to do R3 plus 18 over 5 R1. And then I'm going to switch row 1 and row 2. And that gives that matrix. Okay, so I'm going to stop here because I already know that we have two non-zero rows, which are vectors, and I'm convinced already that they are going to be linearly independent because there's no way of converting one to the other. You can continue if you don't see that yet to the fully row-reduced form, but you can also stop here if you know that they're linearly independent. So these zero rows don't count because these are not linearly independent. So we have, out of the four vectors, two linearly independent ones, which we also know that span H. So now we're ready to solve the problem. So I'm going to say, thus, the set of these two vectors, 1, 4, negative 3, and 0, 5, negative 5, is a basis for H. And by definition, the dimension of H, which is abbreviated DIMH, is the number of vectors in a basis for H. So in this case, the number of vectors is 2, so the dimension of H is equal to 2, and we are done with this problem.